turn my music.
What's up, people? This is Fluffy Bunny, Viva Landroid, and today I got the top 10 apps of the week that you're probably gonna really want. Before I get into these apps, I just want to say again, thank you guys for all the likes you're giving me. Like, for the past couple of videos, the dislike bar is like disappearing every video, and I just want to say thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it, and that's what motivates me to make more videos. And let's get into these apps. So the first app is called Active Lock Screen, which is right here. And what makes this unique and different from all the other lock screens is that, so once you press the unlock button, then you go to the phone icon, you actually can go to your recent calls that you just made. Now I can't show this right here because it has a number. But once you let go and go back, you can go to messaging, it'll give you all your messaging apps right here. You go back, camera apps, and then you go back, you can actually set any app you want over here, and then you can set the phone on vibrate over here, or you can just unlock it, and then it just gives you the time and everything over here, like the date, and you unlock it and you're there. Now you don't even have to unlock your phone to go to those certain apps, it goes straight to it once you unlock it. The second app is the Play Store. This Play Store got a new update, and it's not out for all phones. It's coming over the air for phones, but you can get it right now. I'll put a link for it down in the description. So if you look at the top right here, they got everything categorized over here. Everything over here is like all in thumbnails, clean and just white. And then if I go into apps right here, every single app has this, has these three dots right here. Now what this is when you click it, you can actually install the app from right here without having to actually click it and going through and installing all that. So you see that says install. If you press that, it comes up with this menu and you can press install. If not, if you don't want to do it, you can actually just press it and go look through it like this, like normal. The third app is called Gallery Lock, and what this app lets you do is lock pictures, any pictures you want. Now you just have to go to your regular gallery and you find the photos that you want to hide. So for an example, I want to hide this photo, and this photo. And then once you press share right here, you can go and find the app called Gallery Lock, and you just press it, and it'll tell you which folder you want to move it to. And then if you select this folder, press OK, and you just wait for it to move, and now it actually moved it to the app. Now you need a password to get into the app, and you see you put them over here into business, and I already have pictures over here from before. And you can actually go around to the settings, and you can make the icon itself disappear, and the only way to launch it is by going into phone and dialing a certain number or something like this, I think, and it takes you to the app. And that's really cool, actually. I've never seen that before. The fourth app is called Landscape Wallpaper, and I think a lot of you are gonna like this because if your phone is like mine where it doesn't let you scroll the wallpaper, I recently got an update on my phone, now it doesn't let me. If you get this app, you can select the image that you wanna let it scroll. I selected the same wallpaper I had. So I selected this image, the one that I have right now that you guys just seen that's not scrolling. So you just position it, you press OK, and then you press start live wallpaper. And now it's gonna be running as a live wallpaper, but it's not gonna be consuming as much battery because it's just a picture moving in the back. You press that live wallpaper, and now you see that it's moving. The fifth app is called My Script Calculator, and I really love this app. This app lets you use a calculator in a natural way. Like, I'll just write 2 plus 2, and it puts it into 2 plus 2, and then you just press the trash button and then you can restart. Now this actually takes like a lot of signs. Like if I press cosine, I'll actually get it, but I didn't multiply it, that's why I put a question mark. So if I actually put like 2 squared plus 3 squared, it'll actually get that and give you the answer. I find this better than using a regular calculator because it's just more natural than just pressing buttons. The sixth app is called Google Drive, and this is one of my favorite apps on Android because this acts like a hard drive for you wherever you go. So you can actually install a folder on your computer, on your desktop, where it looks like a regular folder, and whatever you drag in that folder is gonna come to this drive. So when you come to my drive, you're gonna find that file there, and you can actually download it on your phone, or you can send it to another person if they have the same app like Google Drive. This is a picture that earlier I put from my computer, straight from Gmail actually. I didn't have to get the program from my computer. Within seconds, I just went to this app and it was there, it was the picture. So you can do this with a bunch of pictures that you have. Let's say you don't want to send them through email, you can just put them on your drive and you can just open them over here on your phone, and then you can just open them on multiple phones or devices and computers actually, without having to you know, forward emails and stuff like that. And the seventh app is called Best of YouTube. And if you're ever bored, this is the app for you. And if you like watching videos, this is perfect for you. So this app is basically shows you the trends of YouTube. And if you use YouTube on your phone, you'd know that it doesn't show you the trends. It only shows you your subscriptions on your phone. And I hate that. Like, whenever I want to watch the trends, I have to log out. I don't really like that. So if you get this app, you can actually go here and it'll show you the trends of 2013. Now, it says the year because you can actually go back and from the first year that YouTube started, you can go to that year and watch the trends on that year. And then when you take the trend, you can take which category you want. So I'll take science and technology. These are the trending videos for science and technology on YouTube right now. If I click one, it'll launch it straight on YouTube. And then you can just go back to the app and start playing videos like that. The eighth app is called Metal Detector. And this sounds really fake, but it's actually real. I don't know, there's a magnetic device in your phone and this app uses it to detect any metal around your phone. So if I'll grab this, this is my old camera. I grab it and put it on top, go around near the metal. You see that if I go around near the metal, it'll actually go up. And if it goes up all the way, it starts vibrating really hard. So let me see if there's any metal in here. No. Okay, so I got my hard drive and this thing's packed with metal. So if I put my phone on it, this thing's gonna go crazy. 999, and it's vibrating like crazy. You see the graph go up. And I'll show you guys right here that I'm not pressing anything. And see if it gets near, closer to it. It gets it. Like, I find this app amazing, especially on your phone. It's a metal detector now. That's unreal. That's Android for life. The ninth app is called No Crop. And this is for all you Instagram users that when you upload a picture, it gets cropped out. This is a solution for you. So you press this once to rotate it and then you double tap to add a picture. I'll add a picture that's long and that would get cropped out if you put it on Instagram. So I'll take this picture and usually this would get cropped out. You see, it adds two white bars right here. And then you can just press this button right here to share it. And then once you press share, you can take it to another app or you can just take it straight to Instagram and upload it like that. It'll upload it as a square with these two white bars and your full image in the middle. The last app is called Dayframe. I'm not a big fan of this app. I'm only a fan of the like lock screen it has on this app itself. Okay, so it gives you a newsfeed using their dashboard. And then if you make a profile with the app, you can actually like the pictures and favorite them and stuff like that. You can actually change that to your Instagram popular or Flickster, or you can actually add a new, you know, Tumblr, Facebook or something like that to show on your feed. Now, once you press this play button right here, this is what you would use for like, you know, sleep mode or just to have your phone on the table. You'd press this and it gives you the time, the weather, and the battery and the date. Just gives you a slideshow of pictures. If you have your Instagram, it'll show you your Instagram pictures right here. And then if you press this right here, it'll actually take you in the talk mode, but not the app talk mode. And I really hope you guys enjoyed these apps. Make sure to stay subscribed for more apps. Please leave me a like if you enjoyed this video. Make sure to go watch my Draw My Life video that I made yesterday. And like always, Android for life. Peace.